Well, we're very hopeful that the young kids in our program for the last 2 years will show the necessary leadership and chemistry that's necessary for us to have a team that can display all those elements that are necessary to become a winning team and a championship level team and a contender. And I think our younger guys, because of the experience that they have, I think will step forward in that regard. I think they're capable of that, and I think they're ready to take on that challenge. Well, we've been extremely excited and very appreciative of the turnout, the student support in particular, the way that our building was heard and seen last season. I think, you know, there was so much talk about that throughout the year, and certainly when the year was over, that it's never happened here before. So we need to continue that. We need to kind of generate that kind of buzz and excitement with the way that we play. I think our kids have been able to do that very well. Win some games, that always helps. But also rely on the student section to generate some energy and enthusiasm and spirit, you know, in our building and make it a very, very difficult environment for our opponents. And it was so much fun last year. Our kids fed off of that, and it just made for fun games, exciting games, and games that we were able to win because of the environment and the support that we received. Well, with always with incoming freshman players, it's you're not sure what you're going to get. You know, the transition, the physicalness of the college game, being a Division I player now, the grind of things, how hard you have to compete every day. Obviously, being here in school at Harvard, being away from home, there's so many things that factor into young players that it's very hard to predict, you know, how much they can contribute. But we certainly feel like we have a few kids in the freshman class that are capable, and we're anxious to see how that's going to continue to develop and see where they end up. But, you know, we need some help up front. I think Ugo Okam is a kid there that we're going to rely on something with his size being a seven-footer, and then certainly on the perimeter. I think Laurent Rivard is a kid that many people have talked about, you know, being a strong contributor for our team. But time will tell how much these kids can actually help us, the entire freshman class. But we are pleased that they're going to work hard and contribute in that way for sure on a very, very daily basis. Well, I think he's gained a tremendous amount of confidence. I think the kind of year that he had, the year that we had as a program and as a team, and then certainly being named Rookie of the Year, which was such an honor for him and something that he was very pleased to have had a chance to achieve, and we were happy for him. And he worked hard this summer. He was in New York for a summer internship, but he was also working out very rigorously. And I think he added strength, you know, in terms of lifting, but also I think just the confidence factor, you know, that he was able to gain from the success that he had as an individual and certainly with our team. Our schedule has always been an area that we wanted to kind of continually improve and to upgrade as we keep trying to grow our program and build our brand of Harvard basketball, that you know, we want to play very challenging schedules. And you know, we may have overdone it this year, to be quite honest, because we have, you know, without a doubt, coming off of last year, which was the hardest schedule we've ever had in the history of our program, we've been able to outdo that this year, and maybe not by design, but certainly it's on tap for that. And so we have our hands full with no question with games such as Fordham and George Washington and George Mason, and in addition to the BC and UConn and Michigan and Colorado being a home game here, so and others on our schedule as well. But we have our hands full with the hardest schedule in the history of Harvard basketball. It's an incredible story, you know, for all of us, and we're so proud of Jeremy, and he's earned it. You know, we talk about earning and deserving in our program, and someone like Jeremy has worked incredibly hard to position himself and then took advantage of the opportunity once it was placed in front of him. So thrilled for him, thrilled for our program, and certainly, as you mentioned, for our conference as a whole. It's going to be incredibly difficult to try to replace him. I mean, I've said this before, it's a unique situation when you have to replace someone such as Jeremy that was so much responsible for so many different things. You know, our kids have their work cut out for them in that regard, trying to see how we're going to be able to make up for rebounds and assists and steals and free throw percentage, and also for, you know, free throw attempts. I mean, he led us in so many different categories. So I'm not sure that one person can do it. We're hoping that our team can lift ourselves in a way that we can make up for a lot of the things Jeremy was responsible for.